Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about rule tiles in Unity. So let's look at the example. So what is a rule tile? A rule tile is a smart tile that adapts itself according to its surrounding tiles as we paint in our scene. Now if you need to use the rule tiles, you need to download the 2D extras pack in the GitHub. The way how I did this was I downloaded the zip file, and inside the folder of 2D extras master and assets folder, I copied this tilemap folder and pasted that into my project's asset folder. Now as soon as you add this tilemap folder to your project, you'll be ready to use the rule tile feature of Unity. Now before starting to create the rule tile, what I did was I created the tile palette window. So the way to create the tile palette is by going to Window, 2D and Tile Palette. Now I'll create a new tile palette here and I'll name it Ground Tiles. And I'll hit Create and I'll select the Assets folder. Now it's asking me to drag tile, sprite or sprite textures here. So before dragging something here, we need to have a tile map component. So without the tile map component, you cannot use the tile palette. So to create the tile map, we go to Game Object, 2D, and I'll select the tile map. You will see that a grid has been added into your hierarchy, and inside the grid we have a layer and it's called tile map. I'll rename this to Ground Tiles. Now for this project, I have used the sprites that I have downloaded from Open Game Art. First of all, we need to change the properties of these sprites. I'll change the pixels per unit to 128, as I know that each of the sprites here is of size 128 by 128. Then I'll change the filter mode to point, as I don't want these images to blur, and I'll hit on apply. Now these images are ready to be used. Now the next step that I do is I go to create tiles and I'll click on rule tile. So immediately you get a scriptable game object here. I'll name this ground tiles. And in the inspector window, you can see that we have a slot for the default sprite. So we need to have a default sprite for this game object. So I'll go to select and I'll click on the first sprite. Now to this ground tiles game object, we need to add all those tiles on which we would like to have a rule on. So I'll quickly drag and drop the various sprites into it by clicking the plus sign. Now the next step that I take is I'll drag and drop this the rule tile game object into our tile palette. Now if we select the brush tool and start painting, you will see that by default the tile used is the first tile that you have in this hierarchy. So you can change the hierarchy or you can define by default which sprite should be drawn when I use the brush. You can do it by simply interchanging their positions. So now you see that the tiles have changed. So the default tile that you want has to be in the first position in this hierarchy. Now as you draw here, you can see that there is not much change happening in this. So how do you define the rules? So the way to define the rules is by clicking on this hexagonal grid here. Now the way how it works is as follows. So if I click here, then that means that this tile will be painted when there is a tile above this tile. So as you can see, if I zoom this up a little bit, so you can see that all these three layers have one row of tiles on top of them, but the first row of the tiles doesn't have a tile row above it. So it changes to the second tile in the hierarchy. Now you define in the first tile that along with having a tile on top, this tile should not have a tile below it. So you can click on this. So you have to double click on it and you'll see that a cross sign has come. Now if you look at our scene here, you will see that only the bottom row of the tiles do not have a tile below it. So only that row will have the first tile. But as you can see that since this tile will be painted when it has a tile above it and doesn't have a tile below it, so the first three rows don't fit those criteria. And hence by default the second tile will be painted. Now to the second tile, I'll again define a rule that this second tile should not have a tile to its right. So I double click here and it should have a tile to its left. Now you see that these tiles have changed. That's because these tiles have a tile to their left, but they have a tile to their right also. So this tile won't be painted. Instead, the third tile will be taken into account. So you can set the priority of the tiles by changing their hierarchy in the scene. So you'll have to mix and match these rows and you'll see that the tiles change themselves dynamically. Now for this example, I'll make use of the first and the second tile in order to draw a ground. I'll define the rule on the first tile that it should not have a tile on top. And for the second tile, I'll define that it should have a tile to the top and it should not have a tile to the bottom. Now, if I paint it, I'll just zoom it out a little bit. You will see that these tiles, since they don't have a tile to the top, they'll be painted. That is, the first tile will be painted. But when I draw below, you will see that automatically the second tile is getting painted. So Unity automatically detects the rules that you have set in the game object. And this way you can create a tile or a ground for your player very easily. So I hope you understood this tutorial on rule tile.